Namaskar. Hello and welcome to P Guru's channel. I'm your host, Sri Iyer. After a brief hiatus, Sriram Seshadri is joining us today, and we're going to be talking about a lot of things. Small request to all of you to first please like this video, and then also if you have not subscribed, kindly do consider subscribing. Let's welcome Sriram Seshadri. Sriram sir, namaskaram and welcome to P Guru's channel. How are you?
Sir, namaskaram. I'm all right. I'm well. Due to my travel commitments, I was in different time zones, and hence I couldn't, do the show for almost 4 weeks now. Even now, I'm glad that at least I'm meeting all the P Gurus viewers through a recorded event. Another few more weeks, I'll be traveling. So let's see. At least we'll try to get a recorded event instead of a live event.
Yes, indeed. Thank you so much for setting aside the time. It is a weekend where you can probably chill and relax, but instead you have devoted that time to talking to us. So I'm very, very grateful on behalf of myself, P Gurus, as well as our viewers. Sriram Seshadri ji, we're going to talk about a very important topic today. This came out as a controversy, but this is something that all of us need to understand a little bit more. Far too often, we don't understand some things, and that is actually becoming, we become ignorant because of that. It's important to know these things. So two topics like that. One is GST, its nuances, and from the controversy that erupted in Coimbatore, we are going to talk about that. The second thing is the communication issue, challenge that BJP unfortunately continues to suffer from. And 100 days, they have accomplished a lot. But do you see anyone discussing this in the mainstream media? This is the question that we are asking you. These are the two main topics around which this discussion is going to involve. So again, a request to all of you to like this video. I yield the floor to you, Sriram ji. You can choose whichever one first, and then we can go on to the next one. Over to you, sir.
Quickly. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Quickly, we'll go in the same order that you have talked about, right? So first on the GST, the controversy that erupted in Coimbatore when Finance Minister Mrs. Sitaraman visited the Coimbatore. There was an open house with the industrial people. And Annapurna, a very famous chain of restaurant within Coimbatore, Annapurna Srinivasan, in his own, way, I would say that in his own satirical and comical way, he expressed a few things. The crux of the issue that he talked about was a very, very important one. In fact, everybody who saw that, it was astonished the way he stunned people by his demeanor and by the way he expressed the concept. Of course, there are a couple of controversial ones that he talked about, and I'll come to that I'll touch and go. I'm not going to debate too much on that. But the crux that he talked about, the important message that he gave, was very eminent. Number one, he said, I'm in the hotel industry, which is restaurant. I'm running a chain of restaurants. I cook food, all the varieties of food in the same kitchen. So the same set of gas that I'm using, same set of ingredients that I'm using, same set of contractors that I'm using, the people who cook and other labor who are all contract, maybe a contractor or permanent employee, but okay, let's say he assumed that contract labor. So what happens is, there is a GST input tax credit that is there for the ingredients. Say, for example, he uses certain suji for his sweets and then suji for his savories also. So the GST as such is 0% for some of the aspects. Say, for example, a bread or a bun, it is 0%. Whereas when you value at the same bun with a cream bun, it is 5%. Likewise, when you make a sweet out of the same ingredients, ghee and ingredients like the flour and dough that he uses, it is 5%. Using the same set of ingredients, oil, ghee, and then the same set of flours and dough and everything, it is 12% for savories. And for if someone eats the same thing in AC hall, it is 18% GST. So these are all great, because when one understands GST as a structure, this is fine. But what this Annapurna Srinivasan talked about is, how do I accommodate my input tax credit? Because 5% tax, I can't take input tax credit. 12% and 18%, I can take input tax credit. So how do I accommodate those? You know, he even talked about my computer is, gets dizzy by doing all these things. You know, that is the way he satirically he put it forward. But the crux of the message is very important. I think GST Council has to must have a look at it. Instead, how these got propagated was as if GST is a new tax that was introduced by Modi government in 2017. As if before that, none of these products were taxed. The same amount or even more taxation was there for all the ingredients products that he was talking about, the tax of 17 different tax heads are subsumed to become a GST. But how the opposition, including Congress, which attempted to bring the nationwide GST but failed because they couldn't strike the deal with the states for revenue compensation, which Modi was able to do that. So, because Pranab Mukherjee was an architect of the current GST. So, when BJP brought this out, as if it is a new tax that has been imposed on the people. That is how Congress also treats it. That is how opposition states are talking about. Let's dissect some of these. Any GST, state composition, state share, 100% goes to respective states. 42% of center's share, once again, goes to the respective state government. So, almost like a 70 to 72% of the whole GST collected goes to the states. Only the 28-30% remains with the center that they use it for various welfare schemes. So people should understand that once, so when the moment you start talking about GST as if it's only the central government acts as a collecting agent because they collect it at, you know, in a bulk, and as soon as the money is paid, immediately 50% goes to the center state's kitty. The remaining devolution goes in 14 installments. That is, in a year, they estimate it, and every month there is a devolution that is released. So, in 14 installments, why 14 installments? At half yearly, there is a reconciliation happens. Because there is an estimation of, 2,000 crores to Tamil Nadu, because they expect about 24,000 crores would be the devolution that Tamil Nadu has to get it from center as part of the budget. So they do the calculation 2,000 per month and then distribute 6 months of 2,000. Then the reconciliation happens. Maybe, you know, it would have been slightly more than 12,000 they should get. And then they give the remaining. Likewise, in the year end. So 14 installments through which the devolution is paid to the states. So just a month or almost a month delay, the state gets the money. But that otherwise, nearly 70 to 72% of the GST collected is with the state government. So, states like Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Congress in Karnataka, Congress in Telangana, all of them are saying that, you know, GST is as if collected only by central government and then they don't get any share out of it. That is fundamentally wrong. The second, GST, as I said, subsumed 17 different taxes that evolved in the country, including the several state tax and several central taxes. Everything it subsumed and then became a one single tax. What they attempted to do is GST should not be the guiding principle when GST rates were decided was it should not be to increase the revenue, which means suppose a product that was receiving, that you paid all the 17 different taxes put together was about 15%. They put that product in the bracket of 12%. Majority, I'm not going to say that, you know, there were 15% and then there are some 10 different products went to 18%. But majority impact the public, they ensured that it goes to lower tax bracket rather than a higher tax bracket. That is how the grouping happened. That grouping evolves. It is even today as we speak, the readjustments and adjustments and readjustments keeps happening on the GST rates. But who decides that rate? It is the GST Council. How do they do that? When same thing that, you know, when, you know, all the opposition parties talk about center has a 33% vote, so they veto it. Absolutely wrong. What happens is, until now, from 2017 onwards, or even before the GST Council started meeting before 2017 itself. So from that time, the GST Council as a concept, cooperative federal concept evolved, only one occasion, there was no unanimous voting, unanimous decision. Rest of the all occasions, so 99.999 times, it has been an unanimous decision by all the parties put together. Even though center has 33%, they are in an influential position. It has always been unanimous. Never ever a state finance minister came out of the GST Council and said, this rate restructure impacts my state and hence I voted against it. Never ever happened. So either all the opposition parties should come and say, sorry, the center is more powerful. So we fell at their feet and then accepted whatever the proposal that they gave. Or they hide behind blaming the center to maximize their own revenue. These are the only, so anytime viewers, when Congress or the opposition party starts talking about GST, I wish the journalists who are listening to the, you know, the press statements, ask these questions to, you know, those who are opposing it. I wish BJP spokesperson sitting in the media houses or the debates pose these questions for an answer. You will never get an answer. At least, you know, start posing those questions. That is failing. And let's say how the GST Council decides. Normally, it doesn't happen that, you know, someone walks in and then say, oh, here is a rate that we want to change for jute products and everybody vote are against. No. What happens is, there is a council, there is a committee which was created, which gets created. They go to their respective markets, a producer state and the consumption state. They analyze the impact of it and then come and provide a recommendation. The moment the recommendation is made, it is debated and then taken up. And then finally, a decision is being made. GST Council makes a decision. Let me add one more point of view. Supreme Court in May 2022 said very clearly under Article 246A, if I'm not wrong, I think Article 246A is, or 246.1. Yeah, under 246A, every state has a right to decide their taxation for within the purview of the statute that has been set aside for GST. Second, the recommendations of the GST Council is only in recommendatory in nature and not obligatory for the states to follow. These are the pronouncement of our Chief Justice Chandrachud in May 2022 in a case that he upheld the GST Act and then said states have the right to legislate for their taxes. What in crux it means is, suppose there is a rate that has been decided that 18% is a rate, and then the state feels that it is taxing their subjects more. The central GST, CGST, they can't touch it, but the state's share of 9%, they can actually reduce. Actually, the moment you say reduce, they can also increase if need be. So let's be clear on that. So they can also reduce. Never ever any state has done this. They always blame central government and then say that central government imposed this tax on us, on the subjects. And during the state election, they talk about it. And BJP never counters this. They never say, oh, if you are so interested, why didn't your state taxes reduce? For example, Tamil Nadu, one of the highest fuel taxes. No journalist is asking the Tamil Nadu government saying that, finance minister saying that, why haven't you reduced the taxes? See, every state needs this revenue. I'm not denying that. They cannot just run a taxless state at all. But in the US, you know, you would be surprised, right? Sriyaji, you can comment on. There are states like Connecticut doesn't have a state tax.
Yeah, Florida too.
Cooperative federalism. Even for many people go to Connecticut, if people who are in and around Connecticut state go to Connecticut to buy iPhones when iPhone 16 is launched, because it is $100 less there. I'm just giving a number, $100, but you know, it could be more or less, but you know, something it is less there, right? Even a luxury products like iPhone, there's no taxation. State tax is not there in a state like Connecticut. There are about 3-4 states like that for different products. There are no taxation. I'm not saying that, you know, the state should just waive all their share of tax and then survive. I'm not saying that. But it is a collective decision. Or at least show once that, you know, it is impacting my state subjects. And hence, I want them to say that I'm voting against, not walking out. Because PTR Payanivel Thyagarajan, who was ex-finance minister of Tamil Nadu, has not even attended several GST council meeting. Likewise, many GST council meetings goes unattended by several states representatives. But I want to see any one of the state government representative voting against a resolution. Never ever happened. Except once. Never ever happened. Why can't they do that? So that is what I wanted to talk about, Sri ARG, with respect to the GST, right? So it is summarizing it. It is subsuming. It's not a new tax introduced by BJP government. It subsumed 17 different taxes and then brought it into one nation, one tax concept. Concept-wise, rate-wise, it could differ. That's why I said 246A gives a right for the states. Second, every decision is taken by all the states and center put together unanimously. And why do you blame only one party? That's a fundamental question.
Thank you so much, sir. And we will be watching with interest if Tamil Nadu decides to tweak up their rates. Then the new finance minister, Thangam Thennarasu, is probably thanking you. Oh my God, I didn't even know this. So yeah. Who knows who else? So we'll wait and see. Hopefully the people will not get smacked again on this one. Better management is what is the need of the hour. Next topic is 100 days of Modi 3. Lot of things accomplished, but who is knowing all the things that happened? On the ground, many things have been put into play, but nobody seems to know what exactly has the Modi government achieved, except for one article that appeared in the newspaper today. Beyond that, or today or yesterday, I don't remember exactly when. Beyond that, you know, not much has been talked about. I'm hoping that instead of talking about, you know, he said, she said, let us talk about something that is constructive because it benefits the entire population of India. Sir, over to you.
It's a very true PIRG. Viewers, 2000, run up to 2014 election, BJP was setting the narrative. And now, BJP is following the narrative set by the opposition. I think, you know, it's a high time that BJP decides, rolls up its sleeves and then says, okay, I'm going to start setting up the narrative. Otherwise, what happens? It's spokespersons and media personnel, everybody put together, not even talking about in the last 100 days of NDA 3, what was achieved. A significant one globally is Modi's attempt to bring peace in between Ukraine and Russia. Of course, Brazil attempted it about a year back. You know, it failed. And then, you know, Russia did not attend that summit. Even Putin said that Brazil, China, and India are trying to create peace in this region. Only Modi, as a leader, who could visit Russia, be friendly with them, visit Ukraine, and be friendly with them, and be friendly with both of them. In fact, to an extent, what happened, Ajit, there was a small video released by, Sputnik. When Ajit Doval, the NSA, met Vladimir Putin in Russia, as if to say that he was apologizing. He was just communicating what was happening. So that is the level of our India's narrative setting that is happening. So significant achievement in this way, Sriyaji, if you look at it, that BJP is not propagating. Okay, let's come to domestic market. There is about a 15 lakh crore investment on several infrastructure projects that happened between in the NDA 3. Nobody is talking about it. 1.45 lakh crore commitment to defense, then 3 lakh crore commitment to all the infrastructure development, connectivity infrastructure like a road, metro, railways, nearly 2 lakh crore for the agricultural infrastructure development, 4 crore house building under PMAY, then industry stimulus packages. Nobody is talking about it, sir. Very, very unfortunate that BJP central leadership or their spokesperson talk about what Rahul Gandhi said in US. Yes, it is important. You need to break that narrative. No doubt about it. He talked about how can Sikhs roam freely in India wearing their turban, kada, and can they go to Gurudwara? As if they are not. He's still mourning 1984 probably. That where his father made a comment saying that if a large tree falls, there are going to be tremors on the ground. When the Sikh riots were happening, Sikhs were massacred in Delhi by the Congress goons and, supported by the government that point in time in the government. So imagine Rahul Gandhi has an audacity to go and tell in the US after seeing only one Sikh sitting in front. In fact, that person gave a statement later on. Right? I wear my turban, I wear my kada, I go to Gurudwara in India, no fear. My Sikh community is fearless. But this is what Rahul Gandhi does here. That needs to be broken, no doubt about it. At the same time, why are we not talking about the achievements? Why are BJP not talking about the achievements in the media when they come about it? So that is where, the communication strategy within BJP is grossly missing. I can't say about, information technology and social media are probably non-existent. Only the supporters, even Anand Ranganathan, I wouldn't say that he's a BJP supporter, but he stands for some of these policies of, in the media, he defends BJP, right? But BJP as an organization lost its game in the communication strategy. Supriya Srinathe is a far more advanced in spreading the messages. Of course, there are technology companies who are deep state involved, technology companies who are assisting, no doubt about it. But what is your attempt? Why is that you are not making an attempt? Just because, the videos of BJP supporters are suppressed and then Congress supporters are, propagated. But what is then the government doing? Information technology minister, what is he doing? Why is a social media head go and complain about this with the ministry? The government is in your hand. You have the teams, but, I wouldn't say even deep slumber. You're almost in coma. The communication strategy, the ace communicator in the one of the person who is an ace communicator in the world, Narendra Modi alone cannot be your communication channel. Everybody has to do that. I am very, very, anguished to see this state of affairs. Maybe I'm just thinking, Sri Ayarji, we have been in power for 10 years, maybe another 5 years. I think we can go into retirement. If that is the case, at least, please tell at least the public who are supporting the party will realize it and then, do something useful.
Thank you so much, sir. And especially in this controversy about remarks made in front of the finance minister, I mean, BJP could have easily pivoted to the 100-day achievements and talked about it. And people would have immediately turned around because Modi promised that he'll bring in a lot of changes in the first 100 days. And you could have listed them out 1, 2, 3, 4 by using clever graphics and, statistics.
Yeah.
This is a very, very nice way to do it. I'm hoping that itself is going to happen. Let's wait and see. Thank you so much, Sriranji.
One thing you talked about is, one of the manifesto promise was 70 and above the, national
Aishman Bharat.
Aishman Bharat extended without a fanfare. Does anybody even know? Yeah, of course, many people who read newspapers would have known, but otherwise, anybody even know? That's what the cadres are there for. That's what the social media influencers or media is for. Yes, sir. Sorry.
No problem, sir. I mean, that is important, and I think the rules will come out. What you need, most likely, it will be Aadhaar card, because Aadhaar card has your date of birth, and that's all you need. maybe citizenship. I don't know. Maybe because there's a limit of 5 lakhs per per year. I think it's not
per year.
Per year, 5 lakhs. Yeah, per year per family. So there is that limit, but I think it is still that is a 5 lakh that you don't have today. So thank you so much, Sriramji. We'll be back again with Sriramji. He's traveling a bit. We'll work around his schedule, and hopefully we'll be back again in a week's time. Namaskar.